Hello students, welcome to Python online classes. In the last class, I have introduced decision structures concept. Decision structures concept. In that, some portion also has completed in the last class. Today, the remaining part we have to complete in this session. Okay. Now let us start our session. Actually, what purpose we can use decision structures? Decision structures are nothing but if you want to change the direction flow of program execution, for that we need to use decision structures. Decision making statements in programming languages decides the direction of flow of a program execution. All of you carefully observe. I am drawing one diagram, then only you can understand about the decision structures concept. I think in somebody in the last class they have confused it, so that's why I am explaining in this class also about that. This is if condition. If this given condition is true, statement 1, statement 2, nothing but, and so on, statement n. Statements here, this box means a block of code. Block means in C language we have to write like this now. Opening bracket, closing bracket, in between number of lines we can use. Line 1, semicolon, line 2, semicolon, like that, and so on, like n number of lines it can execute. Line n. So here also same thing. See here, all of you carefully observe. If you want to declare any block in C language, compulsory opening bracket and closing bracket must and should be required. So then only this condition will understand. I mean, if you write like this in C language, this entire block from here to here, this entire blocks belongs to if condition. The interpreter can understand. If you write like this, this all statements related to if condition. Here, whatever the condition here we have configured, that condition must and should be true. Then only this entire block will execute. Otherwise, this entire block will not execute in C language. And after that, next levels, next statements, it will execute. Here, next statements are nothing but, in your program may contain 100 lines of code or 200 lines of code. Am I correct or not? So, in that 100 lines of code, these few lines are a part of the program. But this block only execute based on this condition only, based on that given condition only. If this condition is true, then only this entire block will execute. Otherwise, this entire block will not execute. It will skip by the interpreter. If condition is false, then this entire block will skip by the interpreter. Immediately, the execution control will come from here to here. If this condition is true, the control will enter into this brackets, then this line 1 execute, and this line 2 also will execute, and line 3, line 4, line 5, and so on, n lines of code it will execute. Whatever the lines you have configured in this block, in between these two brackets, that all statements will execute based on this given condition. But if you want to execute this all lines of code, this entire block of code, compulsory this condition should be true. This condition should be true. If this condition is false, then this entire block will skip by the interpreter, and that control will comes to the this line. I mean, from this onwards, it will execute all lines. From this onwards, it will execute all lines of code. But only this block of code will execute depends on this given condition. If this condition is true, then only this block will execute. Otherwise, this block will not execute. But this syntax is related to C language only. This syntax is completely related to C language. But while coming to Python programming language, this line is same, but here we need to add a colon symbol. If you want to declare this block of code compulsory, this colon symbol must and should be required. This colon symbol must and should be required. All of you carefully observe. And this is related to C language. Now, this is flowchart, and this is Python example. Here I am writing that program also. If condition, I haven't any chance to open opening bracket and closing bracket to declare the block, because of this is completely related to C language syntax. Now I am writing Python syntax. All of you carefully observe. If you want to declare any block of code compulsory, colon symbol must and should be required. Here one space is also required. That's why I am giving one space. Then only this line of statement related to if condition. Statement 1, again one more space required, because of this statement is also related to if condition. Statement 2, like that, number of lines. Space must and should be required, because of then only space can identify. These complete statements are, how many spaces given? One more space, next line also contain one more space, and this line also contain one more space. So these five lines of code completely related to if condition. If you write without space any statement, then that line is not related to if condition. Here you need to understand one thing. Here if you write like this after if condition, here bracket we already have opened the bracket, and when you remove the space before writing the statement, that statement is completely related to, that before line from here to here, we have declared the block for the if condition. Here I removed the space. Then this line of statement is not related to if condition. Nothing but here opened the bracket, here closed the bracket. Here opened the bracket and here closed the bracket. So from this statement to this statement, block has declared for the if condition. And this if condition is also work with based on this given condition. If this condition is true, then only these five lines will execute. If this condition is false, then this entire block will not execute by the interpreter. Immediately control will comes to the next level of statements. Because of your programs may contain more than more than 5 lines of code. Am I correct or not? I mean, your program may contain 100 lines of code or 200 lines of code or 500 lines of code. Maybe in big projects may contain 1 lakh lines of code, 1 lakh, 1 crore lines of codes, like all those things. But if you want to execute some part of code, then compulsory this condition must and shouldly required. If this condition is true, then only this block will execute. Otherwise, this block will not execute. But condition here, we have to given this condition by using logical operators, by using relational operators and logical operators, all those things here we can use. Because of relational operators, result is what? True or false. Relational operators may give the result either true or false. Either true or false. All of you carefully observe. Here I given one more example. I mean, flowchart is also I'm executing. I mean, flowchart is also I'm explaining by using flowchart. For your understanding purpose, I'm drawing flowchart here. If this condition is true, then this block, this box will execute. This blocks means this block may contain n lines of code, nothing but 1 crore, 200 crores may also enter as per our project requirement. If this given condition is true, if this given condition is true, then only the control will pass to the this block for execution purpose. If this control false, I mean, if this condition is false, if this given condition is false, if that given condition is false, then control will comes to the next line of code, next line of statement. Next levels of statements, next level of statements. Now understand, na? This is the functionality of decision structures. Here condition is nothing but depends on our given decision. If you want to execute this block of code, compulsory here whatever the decision we have configured by using logical or relational operators, then that condition should be true. Then only this block of code will execute. Otherwise, this block of code will skip by the interpreter. Immediately, if the condition is false, then that then control will comes back to the next level of statements. After this block of code, you have to write some statements now in your program. The control will comes to the this line. If this line is available, then the control will comes to here. If the next level of statements not there in our program, then the control will the program will terminate by the normally. Will terminate by normally. Now this is the process of execution, decision structures. So there are three types of decision structures. What are they? If statement, if else statement, if elif statement, if elif else statement. In C language, how many conditional statements we have? How many decision structures? Here I am giving one syntax. All of you carefully observe. In C language, we have if condition, if else condition, and also else if later, and also switch statement, like all those things we have. Switch, all those things we have. So now I am writing each one syntax here. Carefully observe. First, I am writing if condition. Here I am writing syntaxes in C language, not in Python programming language. So if you understand this one, then only Python programming language syntax is also simply you can understand. Otherwise, you cannot understand about that. Syntax is almost same, but using terminology is different. That's it. C language or any other programming languages completely belongs, the syntaxes belongs to from C language. All programming languages derived the syntaxes, all syntaxes from the C language, because of it is the father of programming languages. Starting programming language, no? So that's why. opening bracket and also closing bracket, curly brackets, I mean flower brackets we have to use. In this statements we have to write. This is if condition. And next one more thing is also there, second one, if condition, if the condition is true, opening bracket, statements, and closing bracket is also must and should be required. After that else, how it will work? Else opening bracket, statements, and closing bracket is also must and should be required. And one more, else if later. If condition, opening bracket, statements, and closing bracket, else if, here also condition, here also opening bracket, statements, closing bracket, else if, condition, opening bracket. Here number of else if statements we have to write as per our requirement, but for your understanding purpose just I am writing only two else if conditions. Two else if conditions because of here space not there na, so that's why for your visibility purpose I just have used two else if statements. But in your program, according to your project, in your program you may write number of else if statements. That's why it is called else if ladder. Ladder is nothing but in the Telugu meaning is what? Ladder. Already you have known about na ladder. So like that number of steps we have to write as per our requirement. How to prepare the ladder there at your home? According to your house height na. So depends on your house height, you may create your ladder. Sometimes I mean wooden ladders are there na in the villages. They have prepared the ladders, depends on height. So as per our requirement we can purchase that one also. So like that here also, as per our requirement, number of else if statements we have to write in our program according to our projects. So it completely depends on our project requirement. So lastly, default else without condition here there, it will execute. If how it will execute I will explain clearly, don't worry about all those things. Statements and close this curly brace. Now all of you carefully observe, this syntax is completely related to C language only. C language. So if you want to check one condition, only one condition, for that if condition is enough. If that condition is one, I mean if you want, if you have only one more comparison, only one comparison, so for that if condition is enough. If that condition is true, then this control will comes to enter into the this bracket inside. How many statements we have here? I mean here I have configured only one line, it will execute one line of statements. But if you write more than one line, then this block of code will execute depends on this given condition. So like that, if this condition is false, this entire block will skip by the interpreter. That means it will not execute it. It will not execute by the interpreter. The control will back control will come back to the next line of statements from here to here. If this condition is false, then immediately the control will comes to the next line of statements. Next line of statements. So based on this given condition, this block may execute. This block will execute. Otherwise, it will not execute. If it is true, then it will execute. So one more C language syntax is there, if else condition, if else statement. If this condition is true, then this block of code will execute, similar like if condition. But this if condition along with else condition it will work, along with else block it will execute. All of you carefully observe, if this condition is true, then this entire block will execute, opening bracket, closing bracket, in these two bracket, in these two brackets, how many statements you have to write, number of statements you have to write, that block of code will execute based on this given condition. Compulsory it should be true, then only this block code, this block of code will execute. Otherwise the control will come back to the else statements. If it is false, the control will comes to the else block, else block will execute. But at a time both blocks will not execute. If block and else block will not execute, if the condition is true, then if block will execute. Here if block is nothing but opening bracket, closing bracket, in between whatever the statements you have to write, whatever the statements you have written, that all statements will execute based on this given condition. But compulsory it should be true. If condition is true, then it will execute. If condition is false, sometimes may also false our condition, our given condition, then this block will skip by the interpreter, the control will comes to the else block. This inside whatever the brackets, I mean these two brackets, whatever the statements you have written, that all those statements will work, I mean will execute it. But else block will execute only if the false, if the condition is false, then else block will execute. If the condition is true, if block will execute, nothing but this portion will execute. If condition is true, only this portion will execute. If the condition is false, if the condition is false, then else block will execute. Now all of you have the clear clarity na about this. Next, here else if ladder. Else if ladder is nothing but by if you want to execute more than, if you want to compare more than one value, for that more than one, more than two values, for that if else if ladder we have to use. So if the condition is true, this block will execute. If the condition is false, the control will comes to the else if condition. Again this condition will check, again this condition will check. If this condition is true, this block of code will execute. If this condition is also false, then the control will comes to the this block. Here also it will check the condition. If this condition is true, then this block of code will execute. If this condition is also false, the control will comes to the else block, and this block compulsory it will execute on that time. On that time, because of here any one condition should not satisfy with the true condition na. Here all conditions, all the given condition has false conditions, so that's why else block will execute. If any one condition will execute this entire block from here to here, if any one condition is true, then that related block will execute, else block will not execute. If these all conditions false, sometimes it may also false, so then else condition is also execute. Else condition in on that time compulsory else condition will execute. So that is the process of else if ladder. Em ledamma first ee condition check chestundi, idi true aithe ee block execute avutadi, idi false ayind anko the control em avutadi next statement ku vachestundi, ikkada condition check chestundi malli, idi kuda false ayind anko idi true aithe ikkada execute avutadi, appudu ivi em execute avadu, else execute avadu, remaining part check cheyadu. కండిషన్ ఎప్పుడు కూడా ట్రూ అవటం కోసం పాసిబిలిటీగా ఎన్ని పాసిబిలిటీస్ ఉన్నాయో అన్ని పాసిబిలిటీస్ చెక్ చేసుకుంటుంది మనం ఇచ్చిన ప్రోగ్రామ్ కోడ్ని బట్టి. ఎక్కడ ట్రూ అయితే అక్కడ ఆ బ్లాక్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవుతుంది, అండ్ ఎల్స్ బ్లాక్ వరకు ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవ్వదు, ఇక ద రిమైనింగ్ పార్ట్ విల్ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవ్వదు. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ ఎల్స్ ఇఫ్ లేడర్. సో లైక్ దట్ ఇన్ ద లాస్ట్ క్లాస్ వీ హ్యావ్ డిస్కస్డ్ దీస్ టూ స్టేట్మెంట్స్, ఇఫ్ స్టేట్మెంట్స్, ఇఫ్ ఎల్స్ స్టేట్మెంట్, ఓకేనా? నౌ వీ హ్యావ్ టు డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ద if elif else. This is also similar like to else if ladder in C language. Else if ladder, here elif shortly they have introduced it along with Python software. In C language else if state, else if we called else if. In python we use if elif else, like that we can use. All of you carefully observe. Now I am writing python statements, python. So python if condition, if condition colon symbol. If you want to declare, if you want to declare if related block, compulsory one space must and should be required. Here in Python programming language, this space is also called indentation. Indentation space. In Python programming language, it is called indentation space. Here I am using one space to declare block statement 1 and one space statement 2. Because of this line is also related to if condition. After two statements are over, I don't have any statements related to if condition. So again, I mean here next line of statement I am writing. So for that block is not related to if condition. I mean this line. So that's why remote space statement 1 again. I mean next line, next statement. Actually, what purpose we can use this decision structures? If you want to execute a part of program, if you have 100 lines of code, in that, if you want to execute a part of program based on the given condition, then only this decision structures are very useful. Otherwise, these are not required. Otherwise, these are not required. So, if you want to declare if block compulsory, we need to use this one. For that, for your understanding purpose, I am developing one program. All of you carefully observe. All of you carefully observe. If related flowchart here I am given. All of you carefully observe. Flowchart. This is if related flowchart, if statement. If the given condition is true, then this block of code will execute. If the given condition is false, then control will comes to the next line of code to execute. I mean, this block of code will not execute. So, here I given one example is also. Enter your marks. Enter your marks. I am writing that code is also. Marks equal to input. Input. Enter your marks. Enter your marks. So actually, input function read the input as a string format. Read the input as a string format. So here casting must and should be required. All of you carefully observe here. If you want to print anything, all of you carefully observe. Enter your marks. Ila kuda raayachu. We can use like this. But input is also must and should be required. So that's why input function I am using. We have to write like this also. This is also one way. This is also one way. Here I am using casting operator. After taking input, it is a string format. So now I want to calculate any percentages, then I need to convert as a int type. I need to convert as a int type. Because of input function will take the input as a string format. If you take the string, you haven't any chance to calculate mathematical operations. 70 plus 70, if your input is 70, I mean your marks are 70. That 70 marks you have passed through the input, through the keyboard. Am I correct or not? After that, one more subject marks also you have entered. So total how many marks you have? 140 marks. Total how many marks you have? 140 marks. Input. All of you carefully observe. You can understand everything. Subject 1. Subject 1 and also enter subject 1 marks. Again subject 2 marks is also I want. Subject 2, here I am copy pasted. So 2 marks, 2 subject marks I collected. After that, total marks I am calculating. Subject 1 plus subject 2. First I am printing this line for your understanding purpose. By reading this line, compulsory you need to enter some input some marks you need to enter through the keyboard. So that input may allow means that that input 1 to yellow compulsory input function machine should be required. Otherwise, input is not allowing to enter any characters to the keyboard. మీకు ఇంకా డౌట్గా ఉంటుంది ఒక్క విషయం, ప్రింట్ ఎంటర్ సబ్జెక్ట్ వన్ మార్క్స్, ఎంటర్ సబ్జెక్ట్ వన్ మార్క్స్. ఇక్కడ నేను ఇన్పుట్ ఫంక్షన్ ఏమీ యూజ్ చేయలేదు, హియర్ ఐ హావెంట్ యూజ్డ్ ఎనీ ఇన్పుట్ ఫంక్షన్. నౌ ఐఎమ్ సేవింగ్ ఇన్పుట్ వన్, మై ప్రోగ్రామ్ ఇన్ నేమ్ ఈజ్ టోటల్ మార్క్స్, total marks dot py. py is the extension and save as type is all files. Now I am saving. Desktop is the my location, desktop is my location. So now I am opening for executing purpose command prompt. I am opening here. I think it is small visibility for you. Now I am changing font also. 20 is not enough, 28 is okay. So this is our window. So actually my location is where? In C drive, users folder is there. In the users folder, Siva is folder again. So now I want to change the directory for the desktop. So actually our file saved where? On desktop na. So we need to go there also. Manu akkadiki velthene aa program ni execute cheyagalam aa file ni. Next. So desktop shifted by using cd command. Cd means change directory. It is a DOS command. By using cd command, from one directory to other directory it has changed. So desktop I shifted. So here my file has saved. So what is that file name? Total marks.py. Now I am executing. Enter subject 1 marks. It is printing, but here if you want to add the input here, it is allowing or not allowing? Not allowing, because of input function has not used in our program. So that's why I'm using input function. Again I save it. Again I am executing same total marks.py. So it is accepting input. So here I am entering 75. So if you enter 75, where it has to be stored? So for that, here one variable is also must and should be required. Subject 1 equal to. So again I am executing 75. So it has stored in the 70 subject 1 variable. So after that, same subject 2 marks is also I am calculating. Subject 2 is also I am taking input through the keyboard. After that I want to store subject 2 variable. If you write like this, one more subject marks also it can accept. Now all of you carefully observe, here two subject marks it is taking na. Subject 1 marks are 75, subject 2 marks are 85. So the input is taking down line na, I mean in the next line. By reading this line, actually the input may read from here, then only it is the proper format. So for that purpose I am writing this code like this. These two lines of code I am writing in the simple way. All of you carefully observe, same subject 1 is equal input of, so this line I am configuring there from double quotes, starting double quotes to ending double quotes, I am copying and pasting here. So I am removing these two lines, and this two line equals to these two lines. These two lines are equal to this line. So now I am removing this line. Same it will ask while executing time. For your understanding purpose, I am executing one more time. All of you carefully observe. Sorry, it is showing some error. String little missed. I mean I removed here. That's why. Opening quotes are there, but closing quotes are not there. Okay. Again I am executing. After saving, again I am executing. Enter subject 1 marks, 75. Enter subject 2 marks, 85. It is accepting, I mean 75 accepting beside of this line na? Side of this line. All of you carefully observe. but second it is accepting second line. Input is accepting in the second line. Enter subject 2 marks. So that line is also I am changing this one. So this two lines are I am removing. Sorry, this from here to here I am copying. I mean cut. I have cut that line. Again I pasted here. So this print statement I am removing here. So all of you carefully observe, it is also 75 is subject 1 marks, 85 is the subject 2 marks. Now it is accepting side by side now. So now it is the proper format. It is not a good format. So if you write like that, here it is showing multiple lines and in your program is also contain more than multiple lines. So if you write like this, the code has also reduced na? The code has also reduced. So that's why. Now I am creating one more variable. Total variable. Total equal to subject 1 plus subject 2. All of you carefully observe. Here one confusion is there. Subject 2 marks. Now I am printing. Output printing is also must and shouldly required na? Total. Total I am printing. Again I am saving. Again I am executing. Enter subject 1 marks 75. Enter subject 2 marks 85. Again I am executing. Don't confuse here. So what is the output here? 75, 85. Side by side it is printing. But it has not done by the total format. Here what we are expecting? Total subject 1, subject 2. Subject 1 marks are 75. Subject 2 marks are 85. What is the total? 75 plus 85, the total is 160 na. So what it is showing? 75, 75, 75, 85, side by side whatever the values we have processed through the keyboard, those two values side by side it is printing because of the input function reading the input. The input function read the input as a string format. So strings, if you assign the string side by side, what it will print? It is treating like as a surname, and first 275 is treating as a surname and second 2 as the first name, your name. Like that it is printing. Am I correct or not? So that's why we need to convert. We need to convert by using int function. Input function as easily it will work to read the input in the string format. What it is reading? 75. After reading, the int function receiving that string. The int function has received that input. And again, it is converting as a number format. So for that, int predefined function I am using. Now understand na? Int predefined function I am using. Again, I am saving. Again, I am executing. All of you carefully observe. 75, 85. Now what is the output? 160 we got na? Now we got right output. So that is the process of execution and conversion also. So this 4 lines of code showing this much output. Now you can understand. The total is this 2 line, from proper way it is printing na? Here one space required, then only it will get proper result. Again I am executing. Why it is showing error? The total is total. Sorry, here percentile D. Here percent operator must and should be required. C style it is supporting na. So here what is the total? 160. The total it is printing along with this string 75 85. So now all of you carefully observe, the total is 160. So like that we have to write our programs. So now actual concept is what? Decision structures. For that I am closing this window. I am opening one more window, one more notepad. So marks I am collecting. Marks I am collecting. Input, opening bracket, closing bracket, in between opening bracket quotes, closing quotes. Enter your marks. Enter your marks. If you enter that marks, it can input function treating as a string format na. Again, I need to convert na entry later because of marks are what? Digits. So compulsory we need to convert string to digits. Then only we have to calculate furtherly. Marks. Here I am validating. Here condition I am writing by using relational operators. Marks greater than or equal to 70. Block for the block declaration purpose, semicolon symbol I need to use. One space is also must and should be required. And this space is called indentation. Print statement I am writing. So congratulations. If you got greater than 70 marks, this statement will print. Congratulations. Now understand na? Congratulations. One more print statement is also I am writing. You got a good marks. Sorry, you got good marks. Or you got the good marks. Opening quotes, double quotes, closing quotes. This one is also I am saving. 80. If condition. My program name is ifcondition.py. Save as type is all files. We need to put all files here. Then only the extension read by the interpreter. And now I am saving. This file is also on desktop. And now I am opening command prompt window. This program execution purpose. Now I am changing the directory to the desktop. So that's why I used cd command. Okay, desktop. We have shifted to the desktop. On the desktop, our saved file is available. Now I am executing if condition file. So enter your marks. 75 I am entering. Congratulations, you got the good marks. Now all of you carefully observe. Here, if this condition, this entire condition is true, then only these two lines are executed automatically. Now, same line, same problem I am executing with different marks. Here greater than, what is our condition? If your input is greater than 70 marks, now I am entering greater than 70 marks, I mean less than 70 marks, like that 60 I am entering, less marks I am entering. What it is printing? Those two lines it is printing na here. So this block not executed. This block not executed. Am I correct or not? The control will comes to the next line of statement. This line always will execute. Thank you. Carefully observe. Same 60 marks I am entering. So thank you it is printing. Thank you means this statement. This last line, I haven't given any space. I haven't given any space. So these two lines contain, these two statements contain one space before. Before one space, this line contain. So these two lines are belongs to this if block. So if the condition is true, then only these two lines of statements, it will execute. Otherwise, these two lines will not execute. But the counter will comes to the next line of statement for execution purpose. So that is the process is going on. Now understand na? Same problem I am explaining with else block also. With else block. So here else block is also I am mentioning else colon symbol one space. Here also one space must and should be required. Print. You have less marks. You have less marks. Closing bracket. Again one more statement I am writing. For that I am giving one more space. because of else is also relate contains two statements. This block is also contain two statements. For that opening bracket, closing bracket, opening quotes, closing quotes, in that you have less marks. You need to increase your skills. You need to increase your skills. Like that, that intimation I am giving that student. So same program I am saving, same program I am executing. So what is your, I am entering 60 marks. Else block will execute. All of you carefully observe. You have less marks. You need to increase your skills. Thank you statement is always it will execute. For this one also execute, for this one is also it will execute. Because of the indentation space, here I am not given. So that's why here I haven't given the indentation space. So based on that condition, these two lines will execute. If it is true, if block will execute. If this is false, else block will execute. That is the syntax rule of if condition. That is the syntax rule of if condition. Now understand na? So if condition, if else condition with examples, I mean with practical examples are also over. Now let us come to the flowchart of if else condition. Completed actually, but again one more time I am explaining about the if else condition. If by using flowchart, if this condition, given condition is true, then if block will execute. If the condition is false, else block will execute. This is second statement. This is second statement. Without else also, if statement we can use. Without, I mean with else also, we can use if statement. But the execution flow is different. If the condition, first, if you take the first if statement, if the condition is true, then if block will execute. Like this. If the condition is true, if block will execute. If the condition is false, this block will not execute. This block will skip by the interpreter. And the next line of statement, it will execute. So while executing if else statement, I mean, if you come to the if else statement, based on that given condition, if it is true, if block will execute. If the condition is false, else block will execute. Either if block or else block will execute. But at a time, both blocks will not execute. That is the process of if else condition, if else syntax rule. That is the rule of if else condition. Next, else if condition. Else if is nothing but more than one condition we have to check. The elif statement enables us to check multiple conditions. The elif statement enables us to check multiple conditions and execute the specific block of statements depending upon the true condition among them. Among them, we can have any number of elif statements in our program depending upon our need. We can have any number of elif statements. This elif statements, as per our requirement, we have to write number of elif statements. Depends on our requirement. Depends on our project requirement. But if condition is also mandatory, else is also mandatory. But elifs are optional. If you want to use, then use. If you don't want to use, then not required to mention here. But as per our requirement, I mean if you have any requirement more than you need to check more than two conditions, for that else if are very useful. Else if condition is very useful. Here all of you carefully observe. One flowchart is a given condition. Here we have to write our condition, I mean our requirement we have to write along with if statement. So if this condition is true, statement 1 executed. Statement 1 will execute. If the condition is false, the control will come to the elif statement. Elif is nothing but else if. We have to pronounce about that else if. So if this condition is false, the control will come to next elif's condition. Here also one condition we have. If this condition is true, statement 2 will execute. If this condition is also false, again the condition comes to the second level of elif condition. If this condition is also false, then default else it will execute. Here default else is there na? Default else it will execute on that case. If the given three cases will get the result as a false condition, then else block will execute. If the given three conditions in any, I mean if these three conditions, if anyone it is true, then else block will not execute. First the control will comes to the condition one. If it is true, then if block will execute, remaining part will not execute. remaining part will not execute. If the given condition is false, the control will comes to the condition 2 and it will check next level of code. If this condition is true, else if block will execute. If this condition is also false, the control will comes to here. Condition 3. If this condition is true, then this block of code will execute. If this condition is also false, then finally else block will execute. Else block will execute. For that, here I am writing one more program. Today we will complete this. So actual our requirement is what? Weekday find out. How many weekdays we have? We have 7 days, na? Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. All those things are called weekdays. So today what day? By giving as an input, how it will find out, we can write that program. So input equal to opening bracket, closing bracket, opening quote, closing quote, enter any number between 1 to 7. 1 to 7 only, because of how many weekdays we have already, we have now, na? 7 days we have. So here casting operator is also must and should be required. So opening and closing the bracket, int function we need to use. After getting this input value, we need to store, na? So that's why number variable I introduce it, no variable I introduce it. No variable I introduce it. After that, here all of you carefully observe. If conditions I am writing, no equal to equal to one, one colon symbol. Here one space is I am using for if related indentation. Print opening bracket, closing bracket, opening quotes, closing quotes, Sunday. If you enter 1 as a input, then it will treat as it will print Sunday. Here I am writing elif. Here again I am checking condition number equal to 2 colon symbol, one indentation space for elif function. Print opening bracket, closing bracket, opening quotes, closing quotes, Monday. Next, again one more elif, number equal to 3, one colon symbol, one indentation space. Print opening bracket, closing bracket, TUESDAY, Tuesday. So all those things we have to write. So for that, here I am copying, pasting. Here I am editing 3, after that 4, and this one is also 5. Instead of Monday, after Tuesday, what we will get? Wednesday. Here also Thursday. TAY, Thursday. Again, two elif statements I pasted, 6, and this one is 7. Instead of Monday here, after Thursday what we will get? Friday. Here also Saturday, SATURDAY, Saturday. And finally, if you enter wrong input, for that else we need to use one indentation space. Here we need to intimate that error also, na? Carefully observe. Invalid input. If the user may enter invalid input also, instead of 1 to 7, between, we need to enter between 1 to 7, na? Find out what we have, what today. So if you enter 8 9 10, like all those things, then it will show valid invalid input. That error is also it is showing. So that line we have to write in else block. Now I am saving in if condition. Now I am saving elif elif.py. Now save as type is all files. For that, command prompt. Again, command prompt I am opening. So actually this is a lengthy video, so that's why I am finishing fastly. Cd desktop, changing the directory because of I saved my file on desktop. So that's why I change it to execute. I changed that location to execute that particular file. So what is that file name? Elif. Elif.py. Now I am entering and paste. I mean enter. It is showing one error. Number int enter number 12 never. Input is invalid keyword argument for int. Why it is showing error? Sorry, is equal symbol is there na? Here I wrongly I placed is equal symbol. Now I am removed that one. I have removed and I saved again. Again one more time I am executing. So it is executing. So enter any number between 1 to 7. Enter any number 1 to 7. Now I am entering my input is 5. So on 5th day, what is the on 5th day, what is the day we have? We can find out. Sorry, any number, enter any number between 1 to 7. So 1 to 7, now I am entering 5th day. So it is showing Thursday. Okay, again one more time I am executing. So instead of 1 to 7, now I am entering 9 because of it is getting invalid input. For your understanding purpose, I entered 9 number. So then only else block will execute. Now you can understand everything na? So in this session, decision structures are almost over. And one more concept we have related to decision structures. This syntax is also you have learnt already in C language. But here also one more time clearly I have explained it. So don't worry about all those things. Just simply we can understand. One more time you have listened, then you can understand everything. Thank you. Thank you very much. Today I am ending this session.